Welcome to Crimson Cutouts, welcome to the Complication. We are nearing the end of this build. The final, the last bit of actual making, bit of rawness. I require something interesting on this headstock. And it's going to be a second shot of the alien life form that is eating the body. So what I need to do to start is put the tuners in. We don't actually want to fully install them because then we would have to uninstall them. But this is going to give me an idea of what I need to avoid. Now these are German-made Schertler tuners. I love them. Typical. There's always one. Okay, he's not really necessary anyway. So the question is, what is gonna happen here? So we've got two options. We can just completely just cover the whole thing and have something that has to come off when the instrument is being retuned or anything like that. Or we just have one that just sort of goes around the outside and sits on the top and kind of just sits there. I can't not do it. I'm covering the whole headstock. I don't have a choice. Sorry. Not sorry. Yeah, we're just gonna. So the plan is we're gonna have the Crimson logo as the center bit from which the rest of the thing just happens. This is an offcut from the body. So really, so crank out this one. Let's see the tempo first. Let the routing begin. I'm enjoying this. That was a carver's screw. Very, very useful tool. This is working out. Hell yeah. That's inlay. So what I want to do is take a 10 mil center point bit.
I need to know where those are.
To the bandsaw.
There needs to be half again to start and then really carve down. That's going to be so cool. There we go. I'm going to go and use a big bandsaw downstairs to cut this off.
I think that worked out all right. It's fairly thick. Well, that gives me something to design from. Yeah, I think that works out rather well. Hit the fun times road.
Well, that's a start. I broke my wrist. Not quite. That was hard. In fact, it's still sore the next day. So I've gone home and got my flexible shaft tool because I need it. Hold on. Air filter's on, you can hear that in the background. Still need a dust mask. Because it makes me sound cool. Huh. Or not. Down a rabbit hole. Thanks for watching. I am not gonna bore you with much more of this. I have got rasping to do. I've got final shaping and finessing and all of that jazz. This is flexible-ish, but by no means too delicate for what we have. These air filters are so loud. Come on, get off. There we go. I suppose you want a close-up, don't you? So there's a lot of finessing to do. Of course. I need to check how high some of those parts need to be for the string clearance, but it's doing its job. And it rather matches. Yeah. Not exactly, but definitely close enough. I'm making up a little sanding stick like I did on the bodies. I've done a little bit of shaping and taken the top down just a fraction so that I can sand it, pretty much. When you don't have the right tool, make the right tool. Do not forget these. All right. I have been sanding this now for in the order of about 4.5 hours. I have consumed a lot of Peter McKinnon videos in that time. He's awesome, check him out. I'm so happy this is done, dusted, and we're very close to the end of this series. This guitar is starting to come together, and it's been a long haul, but it's been worth it. Thank you very much for watching. Please click like and subscribe. Please come back for the following few videos, because there can't be very many more after this point. I have got to fit the bridge. I've got to figure out the tailpiece through body stringing dilemma, and glue the neck on, make a backplate, carve it, send it through finish, put it together. We've got a guitar. Oh my gosh. See you soon.